Hello everybody, Flik here, and welcome back to more Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. And I have done one thing off camera since the last time I recorded. Do you remember that I saw that there was a Brachydos going to appear outside the village at night? Well, I went and fought it, and I killed it. Without dying. It was actually quite easy. I used the water longsword I had, and it was okay. Still touch and go at times, and I used a bunch of dash juices again so I could just constantly run from it when it was enraged. But it was okay, and now I do actually have the materials to make the Dios longsword. The reason I haven't done it yet is because I guess I want someone to explain to me why I would bother. If the switch axe is just so much better from a raw damage perspective, from a slime perspective, is it purely because the longsword is faster and slightly more agile? By the way, this is a quest I want to do today, no particular reason. I'm not changing my armor because only one Gigginox means that the antidotes I have on me, plus I have Cha-Cha and Kyumba set to do antidotal on me, means that it shouldn't be an issue. But yeah, I was looking at the longsword, and other than personally liking the longsword, is there any other reason than the ones I just listed that I would ever want the Deus longsword over the Deus switch axe, when the switch axe is hilariously overpowered from a damage perspective? I'm recording this one day after I recorded the point at which I did my first hunt with this on camera, so I haven't seen any feedback on that yet. I may hold off recording any more for a little bit to hear, or I'll ask people off camera again, I suppose. I actually expected both monsters to be on the map at the same time. I am surprised that they are not. And once again, I do not know my way around the tundra. And actually, before I get to fighting, I'm really tempted to go grab the map, but I think he's just through here, and I think it's the Barroth first, the Jade Barroth. Yep. Okay, let's see. Hello there! You are a big one, aren't you? Did I just bounce off him? Oh, I probably hit his head, that's fine. So yeah, I've only fought one Jade Barroth, you saw it, it was on camera. But my thinking was, I was dodging a Deus using a longsword, so really, this guy shouldn't be much of an issue because he's just basically a less powerful, less aggressive. Oh, the constant turning to face me though is going to be an issue from a actually landing hits point of view. Because look, he constantly turns to face me. I might be able to crack the skull though with the explosions from slime. Ugh. Yeah, I may have to use axe mode to get a bit closer to him. There we go, get some hits in now. We're just going to do the old. Oh yeah, see, I can actually swing, I don't bounce off him, but it's technically not doing any damage beyond the build-up of slime when I smack him on his forehead like so. But that's okay, because if I crack his skull, I'd consider that a win. I wonder if I have to do like the chainsaw attack to do it. I'm not sure. What else do I have to cover since last time? Nothing much really, I killed the Brachydios outside. Well, actually, I'm not sure. Oh, no. Did it take me longer than when I was using the gun lance? Which was what, like 30 something minutes? I want to say it was less. It was outside the village, so it's a much easier battleground in my opinion. So I think it was probably a bit quicker. Nice job, Cha-Cha slash Kyumba. And I've not found a good combo to do in axe form. I've got that infinite one. I will always say infamous, I don't know why. For the stored form, but not... Well, while he's doing that, I might as well reload. That was actually kind of close. I forgot that the Jade Barroth does that shark-esque kind of spinning around you. Why would I roll into that attack? I don't know, maybe I was thinking in longsword mode and I was trying to backstep. We can never know for sure. But still, I do like how the... I was going to say greatsword there. Because I'm using it as a greatsword, so it technically is. But I do like how the Deus switch axe looks. And I like that I cause explosions. I am Torg personified now. Can you stop circle? This is the problem I had when fighting the other... that hit me, okay. The other Deus as well. Just... If I took to running away from him, or just, you know, kind of avoiding a little bit, when the shakalakas were down and out, it would very much become this, me walking in a circle and the monster walking in a circle around each other doing bugger all. It's really weird, it's almost like an exploit, but it technically benefits neither of us, so it's just a weird thing that happens, I guess. It's because the monster's trying to line up an attack. but because you're so close to it, you can keep on doing this. Okay. It's a, I haven't seen it happen as much than with things of the, like, the Barroth body type. So Barroth, Jade Barroth, the Deos, they're really, really bad for it. But I've done it with, like, the Jaggy species as well. I'll probably get snowed upon here. Oh, unless I knock him over. I seem to be getting through his... I was going to say poise. It is technically poise. And I know I've done this whole blurb before as well. Oh, right. If you don't have enough charge, you can't do the... That's a shame. Let's try a twin attack. Right. Oh, yes. There goes all your snow. Oh, there's a wall here because I'm at the blooming zone. Now, keep in mind as well, because this is a multi-monster quest, I believe he has less health, even though they're not on the map at the same time. He's going to charge at me, and I'm going to roll. Has that covered everything I wanted to talk about? Yes. I probably will, off-camera, seek some advice ahead of, like, seeing YouTube comments, because I've been in the mood for doing Monster Hunter. I'm still enjoying Dark Souls 2 a lot, but because I'm recording it with Good Rory and CR, they're not in the mood to record it every single night, whereas if I was just playing myself, I probably would record it every single day, at least a little bit. So we're kind of recording every other day or every third day, and that gives me more time for the other series I have doing. So I've been recording a lot of this recently, and I do apologize that the past few parts have had graphical glitches, and because I have to sync up the audio, it doesn't take into account when there's a little bit of a graphical hitch and it throws the audio off. So if I try and write the audio beyond where the glitch happens, then the start is off. Or if I don't do it, the start is fine, and the latter half of the video, or the latter section of the video after the glitch, is out of sync by like a second or so. I've tried to solve it. I looked up, it's weird. I looked up like help on the Elgato, because I assume it's something to do with the capture card. And the basic thing was people were saying, oh, well, you're probably trying to encode in at too high a rate, or whatever, when you're recording. And I'm like, oh, this is a Wii U game. I'm recording a PS4 game. I've recorded PS3 games and they've all been totally fine. Wii U games in general, and especially this Monster Hunter game, not exactly graphically intensive, even if I am recording at like 15 meg per second or whatever the rate is that I usually do. So I found it weird that it wasn't happening with Spider-Man, because I've recorded quite a few Spider-Man parts this time. Not a single one of them has ever had the issue, touch wood, yet, anyway. Whereas with Monster Hunter, it was basically happening to me all yesterday, and I recorded like three hunts yesterday, so... I don't know, but either way, I'm now recording in a lower bitrate specifically for Monster Hunter, hoping... Oh, go away. Go away! Hoping that that will mean that that doesn't happen again, because it really bugged me when I saw, like, my failed attempt against the Jin Moran, and the intense fight I had with the Deos was having audio desync issues because of the weird glitches happening in the footage at certain points. At one point I thought, well, am I going to be able to, you know, post this? Because it looks so bad at points, but I thought, I can't not post two, like, really intense videos just because of a little bit of desync. But desync probably annoys me more than it annoys you. OCD means I strive for perfection, and if I don't get perfection, it keeps me up at night. And I get very frustrated when my videos have some kind of error in them that I didn't catch at the time. But I am occasionally glancing over at the recording, because apparently you can see it happening in the recording, or like in the preview window of the recording, even if you're not actually recording to disk at the time. So that's especially weird. But it seems fine. I'm glancing over every so often. But yeah, so just sorry that there was some problems with the previous parts. Oh, damn, sorry. Kyumba, hit me. Thank you. Other than that, I suppose we can talk a bit about this fight. After dealing with Jin Moran, who I'll have to go back to sooner or later. After dealing with two Brachydeoses, this Barroth has nothing on me. I'm a bit more confident now against the Deos. I got a bit more experience in, as I was saying, because I killed one. I'm far more confident with going in for attacks when he's not enraged. I know now it's actually rather safe. You stay under him, basically like I am now with the Barroth. When he's enraged, though, I still can't... I walked into that, didn't I? I still can't pick my moments well enough because he's just too bloody fast and he can just leap at you from across the map. So the strategy I'm still using, or will probably still use when I fight more, is... Ooh! Almost did it again. Is when the Brachydeos is raging, you keep well away. Oh! Jade Barroth, on the other hand. Why are you reloading? I thought it was full. Oh well. Oh, you didn't like that. Oh! I didn't like that either. I can't approve of getting tail whipped. Oh, he got stunned there by the Shakalaka. Excellent. Is this going to be the one where you spin around on the floor for a little while? It is! Oh my god, I can't believe that missed me. Let's just do a little bit of this. Just slap the crap out of your gullet, oh, and then you'll move. Ah. Oh. Oi, cha-cha, come here. Good boy. Or girl. Do shakalakas have genders? I assume so. I think they refer to themselves as males. But I don't know for sure. Oh, okay. That was quite an easy tail cut. Oh, right. Multi-monster quest. They drop mega potions. Whatever. You moved quite far away, but I actually think that's just out here. Needed the whetstones, actually. Saves me buying them, so that's good. So going forwards, I'm running out of a lot of this tier of quests I can really be arsed doing. It's all like Gigginoxes and Baleful Gigginoxes, and I despise fighting them both, as you'll see when we get into the second half of this fight. So I may just concentrate on the... Oh, right, you're rolling in the sand. On the quest... did I say sand there? I did, didn't I? Snow. On the quest in the other tier up, you know, like, say, the Caricross, the Diabolos, because... I don't even mind fighting them in comparison. I just hate status effect monsters. I guess that's the long and the short of it. I despise being poisoned over and over. I despise being thunder blighted. I'm not sure if that's the correct term for having that affliction, but whatever. Or are you going to go break that special area again? And this is like the perfect scenario because he's not the only monster. I can explore it to my heart's content if I chase him down there. So let's do that and make sure he does it. Oh, there he goes. Yeah. Oh no, he missed. He missed it. Or is he eating? Yeah, he's eating. He was breaking the nest. That is not how you stop him eating. That first hit didn't register. Or is it? It's very slightly clipping him. There we go. Oh, shit. Well, I had to stop him eating, but now I've stopped him being able to smash through there. Bollocks. And he's only going to have mega potions on him, which I do not want. Right, time to play guess where the Gigginox is going to turn up. It'll be a cave, most likely. Probably, I might actually appear right at his nest, come to think of it. Oh, what I can do while I'm here is go grab the map. Because otherwise, I might infuriate people by my lack of knowledge about the layout of the tundra. I can't help it. It just doesn't stick for whatever reason. You know what, I might as well just, the supplies are here, so why the hell not? What is that down there? Psycho Shirt? Yeah, okay, I don't need that. And I might as well just nom on a ration. There we go. Yeah, I think it's probably going to appear up by its nest. Now, which cave is its nest? That's a thing. It's 5, right? Pretty sure it's 5. So I go through to 3 and then turn a corner. Got it. And if I need any more hot drinks, there is some more for me to grab at the camp. So yes, as I was saying, I'm going to be concentrating on the highest tier of star quest I have just because I despise fighting Gigginoxes so much. That doesn't mean that the Caricross and Diabolos are going to be easy. I imagine the Caricross in particular in high rank is going to be a murder, especially if he stays underwater almost exclusively. And it does not seem like he came to his nest, because this is his nest right here. He is out in Area 2. How did I get to Area 2? Area 2 is back where it was, back through Area 3. Fair enough. And again, I've got 10 antidotes on me, plus my shakalakas can cast antidote on me, or antidoto I believe it's called in this game. So one isn't too bad. Based on how quickly I kill this, then I might be tempted to do the one where you have to fight 3 of them in a row, because they'll have less HP. Hey there! Not fought one of you for a little while, especially not since I... Alright, yeah. Especially not since I was able to block last time, so it's been a while since I've had the... You know, the longsword problem, I guess, is the thing to call it, where, yes, I have more mobility, but I can't defend. I'd love to know why that hit me, but I don't really. Screw you, Buildrome. No, that was the name of the boss thing in Freedom Unite. Bofango is the little bastards. Now, that poison thing shouldn't hit me. Good. Now, that's interesting. I'm clipping off the edge of his wing, but if this is building up... I was going to say, if this is building up slime, I'm just going to keep swinging. Thank you, Bofango. You're incredibly helpful. You're credit to team. I don't remember his poison being so pink. Oh, there we go. There's the first rage. I was wondering why it hadn't happened already, given he'd been screaming already. So he now changes which head is active, if I remember what people said correctly, unless they were talking exclusively about the other one. Oh, I forgot you spread poison like that. Yeah, well, I might as well use one of my many antidotes. Can't really rely on my shakalakas to do it quickly. And I have first aid meds too, so that's not too bad. No, or they could do a well-timed heal, that's great. Yeah, getting away from this guy fast enough when he does the stupid poison piles is going to be a pain. I would have the exact same problem with Gunlance, but still worth pointing out. Is he going to do it again? Nope, you're raging, so it's always poison piles when you do this. Ow. So a rage so soon might mean that I'm doing a lot of damage. I want to see if I can break something. That was the explosion proccing and stunning him slightly. Aww. Oh. Antidotal? I'd really love an antidotal right about now. No? Nah, that's alright, I'll just use one of my other ones then. Plenty more where that came from. I forgot how potent that poison is. Look how much it drained off me. I mean, obviously the red bit's going to restore if I let it. But still. Where are you going? Oh. Oh, there goes the red bit. But there's another large cure, nice. I'll just use this, and he's calming down, I think. Or has calmed down, rather. He's changed colour, and now he's just kind of chilling because he's in need of a meal. Right, so I need to work out an axe combo that works. Ah, but this form of weapon does bounce off of him. So that's worth remembering. And yes, I'm aware I'm poisoned. I was giving my shakalakas a time to, you know, cure me, be useful. If he's leaving, then I might as well heal. That Bofango's going to charge me, so I'll just quickly move slightly to the side. There we go. Oh, the other one's going to charge me as well, little bastard. I'll just move slightly to the side. Another well-timed heal. Get rid of these rations and chase him to Area 4, which is right here, so that's handy. I would have known that without the map, and I don't want to hear otherwise. Yeah, I was running towards the wrong... Shut up, that's why! Let's go get him. Yeah, I don't think the switch axe is actually an ideal weapon for fighting these guys. I think a longsword would actually be better, because the extra mobility does mean I have the opportunity to get away before he spits out poison and what have you. I mean, I do have, like, the roll and whatnot, but that's not enough to clear the AoE of it. I swear I don't remember his poison being so potent or pink. Is this my first high rank, possibly? Is that something that changes, like his poison becomes even more potent? I definitely do not remember dying so quickly to his poison. It seems ridiculously high, and it also seems like when I'm doing the quest for three of them I will most certainly be using my poison immunity. I might as well use mega potions because I'm going to be harvesting a few off him when he dies. Yeah, I swear his poison was not as potent. It's almost like it's the equivalent of, say, the difference between poison and toxic in Dark Souls, which is a very significant difference. I can't roll out of that in time because you need two rolls. Whatever. Anybody want to dance and cure me? No. You changing areas? No, you're just going on the roof. Okay. Use another antidote. Get windswept by absolutely nothing. Is that going to be a poison one? No, either way. Nope. That's just a weird ass nest one. Oh, I made him roll into it! And now I need to run and fix my weapon. So, yeah, you rage and I'll just run over here to use my mini wheatstone, whetstone, whatever. Right. Unless it's a particularly powerful one and that's to do with the plot of the quest and I just didn't read the quest plotline. Because usually they don't matter. But something does seem odd about this one. Yeah, I definitely don't remember it being pink. It must be special for this quest. Also, excuse me getting messages on Skype. Oh right, yeah, you're still raging. I should probably not try and attack you. Especially not when you're right next to the zone. If you could chill out over here, that'd be great. Oh, when did my hot drink wear off? I totally forgot about that. Probably a while ago, and I was too busy yammering away or concentrating on the fight to notice. Hey there! Where are you going? So one head bite, that hit me, really? Embarrassingly bad hitbox there. Oh right, I've used up all my stamina. Oh well, if I'm going to get hit anyway, I might as well smack you a couple of times and then just run away and use an antidote. Yeah, I might actually run out of antidotes. I'm going to see if his poison runs out quicker to account for the fact it's super potent. It doesn't seem like it. Oh, he's knackered. Now's like the perfect time to hit him. Either of you two want to cure this weird-ass super poison I've been afflicted with? No? I gave you antidotal for a reason, Chakalakas. And that reason escapes me right now. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be wearing off any quicker. And my Chakalakas are useless, so let's just cure it. Right. Back to it. Ah. Sorry, Cha-Cha. Broke something. Don't really care what, just gonna smack him. Smack him lots. Where'd he go? Oh, he's over there. And he's tired still. Oh, is he gonna do the AoE thing? Nope. He probably will. I've missed my opportunity to attack. Oh, he's still knackered! Are you just luring me into attack or something? Is this like a trap? Hmm. He's walking away. Is that a limp? No, that's not a limp. It's just a stroll. Oh right, even if you break bits off them, they're still mega potions. I should have expected that. Was there any antidotes back at the camp that I forgot to pick up? I wonder. I bet he's raging. Nope. Okay, I stand corrected. I bet he's about to rage though. Where are you going? That's the AoE. Yeah, poison all those guys and then oh! Alrighty. That almost seemed like the baggy spit poison at him. Or, not poison, you know what I mean, like the chloroform. And that knocked him over? I guess the Shakalaka hit him at the same time and that's what actually did it, but I just liked that it looked like the baggies were like, oh hell no, you're not poisoning us, and just knocked the get over. Come on, lure out a poison and then I'll run in and smack you to bits. No, not yet then. Rage time. Yeah, poison them. I want to see how fast he dies to that poison, assuming they can be afflicted by poison. There was an Azeroth running around while I was fighting the Brachydeos outside the village, and the Brachydeos was blowing the shit out of it. As in with explosions, nothing rude. This isn't like the internet. And it didn't seem to be doing anything to him, so I don't think you can like trick the Deos into helping you murder other creatures at the same time. When you killed it, by the way, you get over like 1,000 points, and I got a 5 or 6 star item. I haven't actually checked what I can get with that. It's a lot of work to get one high rank star item to trade to the Agnostic Captain though, that's for damn sure. I'm just chilling out because I'm trying to eke out a belly flop poison, because then it's the longest possible time before he'll do another one in theory, and then I can strike. Plus he poisons more often when he's raging, so I'd rather avoid getting poisoned over and over. Because it's seriously annoying that this guy's poison is ultra potent. But we shall see what happens. Belly flop. Come on, be tired. Oh no, you're roaring again, fair enough. Probably eat some food while he's doing a double roar. Oh, but he stopped being rage. Yeah, you belly flop your way over here, I dare you. It looked like he tail swiped or mouth swiped. Oh, has that changed? Nope, that's just a hanging out on the roof. You're still just walking normally, that's a change of area though, right? No. It's an attempt to grab you and do the tacky thing. My Shakalakas are immune to poison, by the way. I make sure of that for precisely this type of scenario. Oh, don't you dare. Alright, it's just a roar, that's fine. I thought it was going to be poison spit. Come on, do something other than AoE poison. Yeah, belly flop works. Ugh. Well, I got windswept, but that's okay. Is that the... It's another roar, seriously? Where did I get me some earplugs? Actually, you can get your Shakalakas to learn a dance to give you low quality and high quality earplugs. But I kind of like the dances I've got them set up with now, like attack up, recovery up, health recovery, small health recovery, large, and antidotal, I believe it. I think one of them has slightly different dances to the other. I can't remember the exact setup, but I like... It works for me, basically. The only thing that doesn't work for me is the incompetence at which they use or don't use dances. It's like, oh, our hunter friend is poisoned. Let's not do a damn thing, or let's give him attack up small instead. I certainly hope the stupid cats in Monster Hunter 4 are a bit more competent. Is this doing damage? That's doing damage. And it made him roar again! Hooray! Is that a rage trigger? Nope, it's a poison AoE trigger. If you poisoned those to death, I'd be happy, but it looks like they're immune to whatever you're spinning. Which is weird. Slice the crap out of your neck. That's a rage. Yep. It's a rage and a half. How come I get windswept but the monsters around me don't? Oh, that caught me, son of a bitch. Well, never mind then. How many items do I have left now? I've got three. Okay. That didn't hurt at all. Was that a normal egg he just spat out despite being raged? It was. I didn't think that was possible. Oh, now you use antidote! Shakalakas! If I wasn't in the middle of a fight, I'd kick your asses. Must remember that the deflection hits aren't actually doing any damage, I don't think. They are building up slime, but they're not doing damage. Oh, I'm sorry, did I knock your face over? Here, have a chainsaw. I don't even know if this attack is worth doing, but whatever. That's a roar. No, that's an AoE. Ooh, just out of range. Kimba's fled, but he's not dead. Cha-Cha's still in the fight. Right, let's see. Are you limping? No, you're not limping, you're just moving. Oh, you're not raging. It's good. Don't you dare AoE. Get your babies out of my face. Oh, there's an AoE. Well, I'm sorry, did I knock your ass over? Let's kick the shit out of you before you can get back up. Build up all the slime. Oh, the explosion triggered and now he's raging. I wish you could roll through those. Like, if the invincibility frames were just right, you wouldn't get stunned by the roar. I know it makes no sense, but a lot of this stuff in this game doesn't make sense, so one more thing isn't terrible. Oh, the Burabara took that hit for me! It hit him in midair! Nice. Right, so he's raging yet again. This just seems like... I know all the high rank monsters have been raging more often lately. But is it just me? Or are they doing it like more and more often than since I first started high rank? It just seems like they're doing it so much more often. I'm also surprised he's not near death yet, considering I've been hitting him a lot. But that said, I've been getting a lot of deflection hits on him. Which technically do not count. Technically. Yeah, you belly flop right next to the zone so I can't hurt you, that's right. Oh. He's gonna do it, I'm waiting for him to do the AoE, but he's not doing it. That's a belly flop and a half. Who are you going after? That's a shakalaka. No, that's a jump into the zone again. That's fair, that's terribly fair. Alright, he's no longer pissed. What are you doing? Do an attack. That's the AoE poison. Right on Kumba's face. But he's immune, so it's fine. Make him bleed. That hit me. Well, I suppose it did hit me, but the way I was sent sprawling did not meet the or match the power of the hit that did it to me. Ooh, you're spitting a lot. Get in here and talk to me in person, monster. Or limp. I'd be happy with you limping. Boy, the Barroth kill seems fast compared to this, doesn't it? He's knackered, so this is the perfect opportunity to slice the crap out of him. I'm going to roll in case he's about to AoE. Warming effect has worn off. I saw it this time, but this... Oh, I do have time. Very quickly. What's he doing? He's just going to do the head lunge, and then... Yes, I knew he was going to do it. Wait until he's quite finished. Gassing us. Ah. Insta-rage spam. I don't approve of that level of increasing difficulty. It'll just make the monsters rage more. That'll make it difficult. They should have a reason for it. Kimba, that's really not a place you want to be right now, little guy. Yeah, you run away. You run toward... Oh, well. It still does a lot of damage, even though they don't get afflicted by the poison. If they got afflicted by the poison, they would not spend any of their time in the fight at all. They'd be constantly dead. Where are you going? That's a limp. How come he didn't limp at the start, but he was limping there? That was definitely his kind of, like, haggard limping walk. But he wasn't doing it during... Yeah, that was a limp, right? It's been so long since I've seen it, although I did just fight a baleful Gigginox, like, a week or so ago. Either way, I'll wait until he's not enraged and then just go to town on him again. Aim for under the wings so I'm not doing deflection hits. Probably should use the other mini whetstone, actually. So, yeah, you chill out over there. Yeah, you guys better not piss me off while I'm doing this. Luckily, I just need to go whoop. There we go. Ah, Cha-Cha's out of the fight. Kyumba's stunned somewhere. I could kick him. Where are you? Oh, you're okay. Ah, oh, but then you left, you wimp! Ah, right, his rage has worn off. Do the AoE. Come on, do the... Alright, do that. Oh! He was just one slice away. Well then, give me all your mega potions to make up for the ones I had to use. And then I'm going to go read the description of the quest info for this, because I do not remember his poison being that bloody strong. But we shall see. That's right, all the mega potions. How many more can I take? None. Alright. Any mining I can do? Still, two monsters in just over 30 minutes is not too shabby. The Jade Barroth was most definitely the easier of the two. I kicked his ass. Keeping in mind, again, reduced HP because of multi-monster quest. I was saying that, so that Gigginox had reduced HP as well. And he still took that long. Come here, baggy. There you go. It's probably enough to kill you. Yeah, it is. Anything else to mine? Oh, yeah, there is in the distance over here, but I don't think I'm going to get to it in time. Come on, it all relies on this. There we go. That Earth Crystal was massively important. I tell you it was. I better get a lot of quest rewards. That's all I can say. What do we get? Ah, we got a commendation. Carapace, hide, hide, carapace. What was that? It was like a venom gland or something. That's new. Maybe that was my first high rank Gigginox, and that's why he's just much more vicious from a poison perspective. Send equipment, speed setup, plus one. That's awful. Just awful. That was a new record, and a new record. Nice. So we'll save. We shall glance at the gamepad, although I doubt there's anyone to talk to, given that that was a previous tier quest. I don't think they count towards the next urgent unlock. But we'll see. Nope, no one to talk to, as expected. Let me just check the description of that mission, quest, objective, whatever. What was it? Yeah, it was the right stuff. Barroth and a Gigginox. No, it must just be that the high rank Gigginox's poison is more potent. It must be. Therefore, I will be using the poison immunity armor when I have to kill three of the bastards. But still, I think that means I don't have anything to look at, really, because I was just killing stuff I've technically killed before. Oh wait, it was the Baleful Gigginox's armor I looked at last time, right? So there should be a, like a... let me see here. Gigginox, that's the Baleful Gigginox set. So is there not just a high rank version of the regular? Have I already had it and looked past it? Probably. I wouldn't put it past myself to have done that. Meh, either way it's not something I'd use. So I will say thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video and enjoyed the series in general, please consider leaving a like, it helps out a lot. Oh, and actually I could see what I could get for my super rare trade. So I got a large obsidian from a Brachydeus that I killed outside the village. So that is 5 stars. What can I get for 5 stars? I could get the Stink Mask. It's a dung bomb, okay. Can't afford the Whetstone Mask or the Idol Mask. Or that, or that. I could get a Serenity Lamp, but that's just like for decorating your house, so... Don't really need that. A Bowgun Codex. To unlock a weapon, I guess. Twisted Horn. This is all just stuff to put in your bedroom, so I don't really need any of that. No, I don't know. I don't know. Should I get the stink mask? Let me know. I won't spend it now. You can just let me know. Cancel the trade, yes. So, anyway, my name has been Flik. This has been Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more. And ta-ta for now.